Thank you guys for joining us. My name is Allison Lewis. As I said, I work in the Office of Information Technology. I work with the team that supports our Orion student information system, but we also work hand in hand with the teams that support the Gemini HCM and Gemini FMS and our PeopleSoft security teams. Today, I am here to do a presentation about the upcoming changes that are coming for Galaxy and the PeopleSoft systems. In collaboration with campus administrative offices, we will be implementing the new Galaxy and the new user interface for the PeopleSoft systems called Fluid. At this point in time, our go live date is set for March 8th. Just keep in mind, since we lost a week of work last week due to the winter weather, we are playing catch up a little bit, but we do intend to meet that go live date. But if there is something that pops up that is a showstopper, our next go live date will be 1 week later on March 15th. Currently, the Galaxy portal that we all use and are familiar with is an Oracle product. It is no longer supported by Oracle, and the look and feel of it, the interface, is outdated and not very friendly looking. UT Dallas Web Services is building a new UT Dallas hosted web page that will be our Galaxy launch page for Orion and Gemini FMS and Gemini HCM. The new user interface for Orion FMS and HCM is called Fluid. It is an Oracle product. Our systems are an Oracle product, and Oracle released this new user interface a few years back, and UT Dallas is now rolling that out to our campus. This is a sneak peek of what the new Galaxy launch page will look like for our to log into the system. At the top of all of the utdallas.edu web pages, there is a link. There's a link for Galaxy that will now redirect to the new Galaxy web page. So if you have bookmarked the current Galaxy web page, we do suggest that you delete that, and you can use galaxy.utdallas.edu, and that will get you to Galaxy. On this web page, as you can see, we have two boxes for the we have two boxes at the top. We have one for Orion and one for Gemini. The reason we have two boxes is that our applicants and students have no reason to go into Gemini. Unless they're a student worker. So they will utilize the Orion link, and staff and faculty can utilize either Orion or Gemini, depending on which one you're more comfortable with or which one you do the majority of your business in. The three systems will be integrated. So if you go into Orion, you will still be able to see Gemini FMS and Gemini HCM things without having to come back out to Galaxy like we currently do. You can see that we also will have a box here where we will be storing our Fluid training documentation. We will also be linking to videos such as this one that we're recording from this webpage as well. At the bottom of the page, we have commonly used links that existed on the previous version of Galaxy. As you can see, there's not as many as there currently are in the current Galaxy, and that is because a large portion of the links that are in the current Galaxy are actually PeopleSoft links, and those will remain within whichever PeopleSoft system they go to. These links that we have here are typically external websites such as Jira, My Parking, OnBase, Teams, etc. All right, This is a example of what the new fluid interface will look like. This is a homepage. Within that homepage, you have several different elements that we want to spotlight for you. In the middle of the page, you have tiles. Your homepages will consist of tiles. In the top middle of the page, you have the homepage navigator. That is where you will click in order to see all of the homepages that have been provisioned to you based on your PeopleSoft security access. On the upper right, you have different options that you can select. You have a button for home that will take you back to your default homepage. You have a search function. The bell will be your notifications. You have three dots that will be a button for actions. That is the actions list. And you have a compass button that is the nav bar. Here are a few examples of homepages that have been built for different administrative users on campus. Keep in mind that homepages, tiles, and the contents within those tiles are driven by your current PeopleSoft security. This project is strictly a user interface project. It is not a security change project. So the access that you have currently in PeopleSoft is the same access that you will have after this. It's just the look and feel that will change. You can see here, this is the example of the Bursar's homepage. What we have done is we've created a homepage for their office, and depending on the office user's security, they will see different tiles whenever they log into the system. For example, the people that do the student financials cashiering at the front desk do not also have the refunds tile. Another example is the faculty homepage here. This is what our faculty will see when they log in. They will have their UT Dallas Faculty Center tile. They will have two tiles that are instructions and or tools. They have their faculty instructions and information, and then they have faculty course and tools. These two tiles link out to external websites that UT Dallas hosts. Whenever you select a link within one of these tiles that goes to an external website, it will open in a new window or tab, depending on how your internet browser is set up. The faculty also have the search classes and catalog option. And then if a faculty member is a grade change approver, they will be provisioned this approvals tile. The approvals tile will now replace what is currently in the wait list link. So if a faculty has a grade change that they need to approve, they will see this tile, and the zero on this tile is dynamic. It will display the number of approvals that they have to take a look at. The function where you receive an email for approvals, workflow approvals, will remain the same. You'll click on it and authenticate and go and do your approvals like you do now. This is another example of a dynamic homepage. We have the student affairs